My name is Sophia Dubrovich. I'm a longshore worker for the International Longshore and Warehouse Union, part of Local 13, as well as a community advocate.
My name is David T. Ross, Jr., and I am part of the International Longshore Warehouse Union, Local 13. I am from San Pedro, California, as so is my father and my grandparents were before me. I lost my father at the age of 19, passed away of pancreatic cancer. Health is very important to me, whether it's taking care of yourself at home, cleaning up your environment, right, eating right. Those are things that are very crucial to me because I saw what my father went through, and I hope that the next generation doesn't have to go through that as well.
The LA Long Beach Port Complex remains Southern California's largest single source of pollution. Neighboring communities are hit the hardest by the emissions from the ships, trucks, locomotives, and cargo handling equipment. But this pollution also impacts the rest of Southern California, increasing smog as far away as the Inland Empire. Green hydrogen, which is hydrogen produced from renewable resources, is key to our clean energy transition away from fossil fuels, especially in hard-to-decarbonize sectors. Historically, hydrogen for industrial uses has been produced from fossil fuels. Today, we have the technology to make hydrogen from renewable resources like wind, solar, and organic waste.
So in 2016, I realized that to rapidly decarbonize every sector, we were going to need an alternative fuel. Hydrogen has been around for many, many decades. It's a mature industrial commodity. Almost 100 million metric tons are produced and sold and traded all over the world today. One of the reasons I'm so excited about green hydrogen is not only is it an opportunity to reimagine our energy system away from one that's based on fossil fuels to one that's based on renewable resources, but it's also an opportunity to reimagine our energy ecosystem, considering the community value proposition, considering skilled family-sustaining careers in clean energy, and making sure that the men and women who have worked on our energy system for the last 100 years and our community members who have suffered from the effects of fossil fuels are included and benefit from this transition that we're undergoing today. Diesel use in long-haul trucking and port logistics is one of the largest sources of pollution in and around ports for communities. Fenix Marine Services is the second largest terminal operator in the combined ports of Los Angeles and Long Beach. And they are showing terminal operators all over the country how to make progress with green hydrogen and directly displace diesel use here at the port.
Hydrogen is one of those things that's like a Swiss Army knife of energy. Right now, we're focusing on the cargo handling equipment. We've taken a previously fossil fuel burning asset that hit its high hour mark of 25,000 hours of operation. And typically what's done at that point is the asset is sold off to South America or another market where it would continue to pollute. Toyota Tsusho and US Hybrid are our partners on this. And they converted it to a hydrogen fuel cell powered top handler. We have a couple hundred hours of operating on it so far. The machine just left our terminal to go back to US Hybrid for its final modifications. When it comes back, fully expected to outperform its diesel counterparts. We feel like it's going to really help us achieve our energy goals. We endeavor to be zero emissions by 2030 if we were in a position to switch every fossil fuel burning asset to green hydrogen in the LA port complex, you would have an instant air quality improvement.
The pollution in this area, in the LA and Long Beach area, has a tremendous effect on all sorts of communities in the area, such as minorities, even older folks, and especially the working class here at the ports. I see the source of the pollution being right here in the port area.
I love the idea of converting to green hydrogen. Retrofitting with a fuel cell can keep human-operated cargo handling equipment clean and operable by our brothers and sisters down at the port.
My first impression that it was intriguing. It was intriguing because it was something new, something I hadn't thought of, I hadn't looked into. I had to look at safety because one of my primary functions is the safety of my membership on the job. If you're willing to accept the risk of traditional petroleum products, there's no greater risk with hydrogen. As a matter of fact, in my opinion, it is less. My advice to hydrogen, everybody, is simple. Approach it with an open mind. If you approach it with an open mind, you'll come up with the same conclusions that I have. this is the future.
I also think that the union would embrace this technology because at the end of the day, we go back home, we invest into our neighborhoods, we give back to the community, and we want to help protect our community and have our children be raised here in this community. So clean environment, great paying jobs, I'm all for it.
A terminal or port ecosystem is the perfect place to prove green hydrogen can decarbonize hard to decarbonize sectors. If we can prove it works here, we'll be a shining example for the rest of the world about what can be done.
The challenge to faster adoption of renewable hydrogen and alternative fuels is scale. And because all of these technologies are commercially available today and they have not scaled, they tend to be higher cost than the fossil fuels we use today. So the chicken and egg problem is, how do we scale to drive down cost? And the answer to that is in infrastructure. Infrastructure that can help us produce the renewable hydrogen at large scale, safely transport it, store it, and deliver it to end users who are currently using diesel and gas and enable them to rapidly switch over. Projects like this is how we advance cleaner, healthier communities, combat climate change, and reduce our reliance on fossil fuels. With green hydrogen, we can achieve a clean and just energy transition right now.